Hello everybody, camera 58 is the Petri 2.8 made by Kuribayashi, a Japanese company that started making cameras in the late 19-teens. It's not the Petri 35 color corrected Super 2.8 dating from 1954 and not part of the green-o-matic versions begun in 1958. This particular variant with the zebra stripe exposure guide on top is from 1957. There were also F2.0 and F1.9 versions. From what I can find out, the F2.0 was similar and the F1.9 had different controls and a faster shutter. It has a sharp coated 45 millimeter Petri Oricor lens. It's a Tessar type lens with four elements and three groups. F-stops are from F2.8 to F22 set on this lens dial in the middle. The shutter is a Petri Carperu with five blades and speeds from 1 second to 1/300th of a second plus bulb. And it's set on the forward dial here. That helps date the camera to 1957 because the 58 green-o-matics, where this whole section was covered under a green glass, switched to the Copal shutter with a top speed of 1/500th of a second. It has a nice bright coupled rangefinder. There are no frame lines, no parallax corrections, so you have to be sure to leave a little space in the viewfinder. Make sure you don't cut off your subject. Focusing is with the innermost ring or this nice big precise knob. There is depth of field scale on the lens, and the lines line up with your focal distance markings for street shooting or nice tight control of your focal plane. It has a cold shoe and an X-sync socket on the side of the lens. Like the Petri Racer that I reviewed for week 20, you don't open the back by lifting the knob. This one has this little lever on the left side. You do lift the rewind lever to load the film. The rewind is kind of a clever hybrid of the transition between a rewind knob and a rewind lever. Lift this up and you have a nice little knob for cranking it. A little pressure to the left, push it down, it sits flush with the knob. The film speed dial is just a reminder since there's no meter. Once you load the film, set the film counter to A and then wind and fire until it's at 1. Frame counter is just a counter, so it'll work even through the whole roll, even if you forget to set it. Do set it though so you don't accidentally run out of film right when Bigfoot appears. This particular copy has had some hard knocks. The badge is missing. It's got this dent in the filter ring. Functionally, it's great with just an external cleaning. The 58-year-old shutter, even the slow speeds, aren't far off the mark. One bummer is I didn't get even the lower half case and there aren't any strap lugs, so I have to be really careful not to drop it. The F2.0 versions and F1.9, they're hard to come by and kind of expensive, but I think these old Petri cameras are really underrated and really undervalued. Pick one up for next to nothing and see for yourself. I'm going to run another roll of very expired Lomography color print film through this, and I'll see you then.